Hello, we're the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today's episode is once again mostly Starship updates with the exception of a couple of articles. After which we'll take a look at the Boca Chica launch area, further SN4 testing, SN5 build and also SN6. Let's head straight in and get up to date. Starting with this article about the possibility of NASA using Falcon Heavy as a launch vehicle for the Artemis Gateway. We already know that the Dragon XL will launch on a Falcon Heavy to deliver supplies to the Gateway. However, in this article, whilst there is nothing concrete and NASA hasn't selected a launch system yet, it talks about how NASA had to assure themselves of a vehicle that could do it, that being Falcon Heavy. Next up, we have an article about astronomers' reactions to the new news about reducing Starlink brightness. I recently showed you the blog post from SpaceX on Starlink reflectivity efforts, which they seem to be pleased with. Whilst it says that astronomers don't know if the measures will work yet, they say that they are hopeful it will help fix the problem. Other than those two articles, there's not much else to talk about, so we'll head over to Boca Chica. Here you can see that workers are constructing a new test stand. With SN4 still alive and SN5 getting close to ready, along with SN6 coming together at pace, this makes a lot of sense. You can see here that they've also installed what I believe is for either a fire or the sound suppression system. The company seems to be outpacing itself, with production seemingly catching up with testing. I think that it would be really cool if we got to see two Starship prototypes sitting on test stands at the same time. Here's the other thing I want to show you at the launch area before we move to some quick Starship stuff. You can see here a vehicle belonging to Fugro, and this particular vehicle is a cone penetrometer system. I did a bit of research and it looks like this is used for testing and characterizing soil. I'm guessing based on what I've read is that this will help with the foundations for big buildings such as the launch tower. Let's now take a look at some Starship stuff that I've come across. First up is a cool timeline somebody called Wes created and posted to the NSF forum. It gives a great perspective of the speed at which SpaceX has progressed through each of their Starship vehicles. Starting with SN1 through to SN6, it's incredible to see how much has been done and then to consider that this is only the beginning. Further rings have also been moving around, particularly near the new ring fabrication building as you can see here. However, my question right now is what rings are we seeing? We already know that there are some stacked SN6 sections. So maybe these are for the missing SN6 segments, but we could also be seeing SN7, but it's too early to tell. Also in this clip, I thought that I would point out that you can see some bulkhead sections in the bottom left. These could very well be for SN7. With Boca Chica and SpaceX info covered, we'll move on to SN4, which as you can see here is still standing. Over the last week, this vehicle has been through many a test and lives to tell the story. Wednesday, May 6th, on the evening of my last upload, SpaceX performed yet another staticfire test. Once again, it was a success as you can see here. So this vehicle has done a bunch of pressure tests, pre-burner tests of the engine and two successful static fires, absolutely amazing. After the second static fire, Elon Musk was asked if it was a success, to which he responded with yes, static fire feeding from fuel header versus main tank. Musk was also asked about the methane flare stack, which we saw last episode got a bit wild as to whether or not it was of concern. He responded to say, flare stack flamed out, in a few weeks we'll be recondensing methane using solar power, so no flare stack. Whilst I'm no expert, I have read that the reason for the flare stack is to burn off extra fuel when the tanks reach dangerous pressure levels. Elon Musk elaborated on the solar power method to say, in this case, just chilling the gas back to liquid. Still on SN4, let's take a look at the Raptor engine that recently performed the static fires. You can see here that since the second static fire, it has been detached from the vehicle. Also, it appears that this Raptor was SN18, which has had quite a ride since its birth. Months ago, it was in McGregor on a vertical test stand, then moved over to Boca Chica, after which it was obviously attached to SN4. Finally, for SN4 in the test area, you can see here that the hydraulic rams were moved back over to the prototype. These rams have also had workers reassembling it in preparation for being reattached to the launch mount. As you can see here, those rams have been reinstalled underneath. Not only that, but I believe that SpaceX last night may have also done another pressure test as you can see here. Whilst it was definitely not a full cryo test, it seems like something happened pressure-wise. Something I want to share with you since I found it useful is a tweet from Rafael Adami explaining the different test indicators. So when SpaceX are doing pressure tests, these are the indicators as to what's happening in the tanks. You can see here that there are still dates posted by Cameron County for road and beach closures. Some of these dates have obviously already passed, with the next primary testing date being May 11th. What they'll utilize that date for though, I'm not entirely sure. Now for the final parts of the video, SN5 and SN6, starting with the SN5 thrust section, which was recently seen outside. Here we have the upper part of the bottom section, which contains the new and improved thrust park. Then there's also the very bottom rings for this thrust section, which were also outside for stacking. As you can see here, that's exactly what happened next. Both of these sections were put together. Also for SN5, you can see that the upper bulkhead for the tank has also been stacked in the high bay. Engineers are continuing to work on it, and behind the nose cone you can see that the thrust section is hanging out. They've also attached the lifting mechanism, so we all know what that means. Very soon, SN5's tank section will be stacked. With what Elon Musk said previously about SN5 having a nose cone and possibly flaps too, it seems that there's still quite a bit to do. Last thing for SN5 is Raphael's latest build diagram, and it's looking amazing. I just can't wait for testing. Finally, SN6, which we haven't seen much of recently, has popped up. Here you can see some stacked rings for the liquid oxygen tank section. I'm not sure if there's a common bulkhead in there yet, but it's possible that the next step for this section is sleeving. Like we normally do with each Starship construction, here's the latest SN6 build diagram from Raphael Adami. Thanks to him for keeping up with the fast and constantly changing builds. Like usual, I reserve the end of my videos to say a massive thank you to Mary BocaChica Girl for her amazing work in capturing the progress. Also, thank you to the NSF team for sharing it with us. You allow us an unprecedented view into the future, so we get to witness spectacular things. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.